It's fun and exciting to shop for houses. Paying for a house is a different story.
Bryan Buhr, a real estate agent at Berkshire Hathaway Home Services Premier Properties, is here to talk about some things to consider to avoid being what's, I guess, apparently called house poor. Welcome back to the show, man.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
So house poor, what does that mean exactly?
Yeah, so house poor is just a general term that kind of says, you know, after you pay all your other bills and your mortgage, there's not a lot of money left over to do fun stuff like go to the lake or or even go to a movie or simple things like that. So, you know, and since your mortgage is usually your biggest payment, it does feel like your house is kind of closing in on you. So yeah, definitely something you do want to avoid.
So how can a real estate agent help buyers from, you know, suffering from being house poor?
Right. So quite a few ways. And the one thing that I like to do if a client is willing to is kind of avoid being normal poor. And normal poor, I mean, is when your student loans, your credit cards, all these other things are kind of coming at you before you even look at houses. So if someone is willing to, you know, it's nice to meet with them, kind of have a plan for those things even before we start shopping. A lender is going to pre-approve you to a certain amount. That might not fit your lifestyle, you know, so you don't want to necessarily spend everything you can on your house, especially if you're someone that likes to have a lot of fun and travel and spend your money in different spots.
Especially we need to have that Zorba's house. Budget.
Yeah,
about like,
yeah, absolutely, yeah, because Zorba's ain't cheap.
Don't want to cut into any margaritas there.
So you start going down this journey of buying a house, and all of a sudden these unexpected costs start popping up. What are some of the most common things people miss?
Yeah, so there's a few things that people don't think about, especially if you're buying your first house or say you're moving from an apartment to a house. You know, maintenance is one thing, you know. So say you finally get out of that apartment, you have a house in that nice backyard. Well, you're going to need to take care of it somehow. So either you need to budget for a lawnmower or hire someone to come take care of it for you. You know, snow removal, that's something that people don't think about, but it can add up. You know, so there's your maintenance. Then also utilities, that if you had an apartment, maybe that was just, you know, maybe your landlord paid for your heat and you just paid the same. Well, now this is something that you need to budget for. It can really be a lot if you live in a rural area. So say you have your own propane tank. Instead of a fuel bill every month, maybe once or twice a year, you get hit with a big bill. So it's planning for stuff like that, because those big expenses can make, you know, buying a house and living in a house should be fun, and those things can make it feel not so fun, and we want to avoid those for sure.
We used to joke that house poor meant like a big, fabulous, beautiful house with no curtains in the windows, because there are a lot of other expenses. You're talking about the important ones, like, you know, having a lawnmower, but it could be a lot of things, like decorating your home or filling it up with new furniture and things like that.
Yep, it really can be. And yeah, and when you say house poor, yeah, it is almost like you are making good money, you have a really nice house, and the cost of it just makes you feel poor, and then you better like that house because you're going to be sitting there with nothing to do. So, like I said, it's something, everybody is different. That's where we really can come in, see what someone's lifestyle is, and just make sure, you know, kind of warn them, say, hey.
Rein them in a little bit sometimes.
Right, you know, and everyone's personality is different. Some people don't spend a lot of extra money. So someone like that can kind of, you know, shop at the top of their budget.
Yep. Most importantly, as we can see here, how can people get a hold of you?
Yeah, the easiest way is by my cell, 218-850-2004. I also have a website, www.fmtothelakes.com. Obviously work in Fargo and then quite a bit out in the Lakes area as well. So.
All right. Always fun to visit with you.
Yeah, thank you so much. It's always nice to come on with you guys.
Appreciate it, man.
All right, coming up next, we're celebrating our local wineries with a wine trek. We'll tell you how it works next.